Hello friends, Mandar here. I'm back with another video. Today I have some good news for EB1 category of employment-based immigration to United States. Also some good news for EB3 as well. So the visa bulletin for August 2020 just came in last night and it was published on the Department of State website. And I thought I would give you some updates on this latest visa bulletin that came in as we are seeing some progression in the dates, which is good news. And I will also give you a reason why I think these dates are progressing. So if you are interested in this video, please stay tuned until the end and let's get started. If you are here for the first time, welcome. My name is Mandar and I make immigration related videos for US and Canada. So the visa bulletin for August 2020 just came in last night. Usually it is published around 15th of every month, but this time we are seeing it a little bit late, which is not surprising. I'm seeing that trend in last couple of months. But nevertheless, it is here and we are seeing some date changes and movements. Before going into the employment-based category, I just wanted to mention that the F2A category in family-based is still current. So which means spouses and children of permanent residents are able to apply for a green card and they have the visa numbers available right away, which is good news. Now let's look at the employment-based category 1, which is EB1 category. The only two countries that are retrogressed in this category are China and India. And we have seen some big jump in the progression of dates for both China and India. For China, it is about 6 months of progression, and for India, it is about 9 months of progression, which is incredible given how much it had been stuck for the last couple of years. People who have been in the queue, especially from India, know this very well, that these dates don't change very often. And seeing the forward movement of these by 6 months and 9 months is really incredible. So EB1 category applicants have some reason to rejoice. So enjoy. If you have your petitions pending and if you are within this date range, you may apply for adjustment of status. Now, not so good news for EB2 category. Let's look at the visa bulletin side by side. The dates for China have jumped from August 22nd of 2017 to February 8th of 2018. So that is a jump of almost 6 months. And as you can see, the dates for India have jumped from May 8th, 2017 to February 8th, 2018. That is a jump of almost 9 months. This is very, very rare. Now, not so good news for EB2 category. As you can see, for China, although it has jumped for 2 months from November of 2015 to January of 2016, but for India, the date is exactly the same from July to August visa bulletin, which is very, very rare. I have seen the dates progressing forward at least by a few days, but I have never seen that they haven't moved at all. Maybe I have missed them, but this is a surprise to me that EB2 dates for India have not changed. So sorry folks for EB2 India, you will just have to wait a little bit longer. But I have a theory that these dates are going to move irrespective of the category EB1, EB2 or EB3. Let's go down the list. EB3, as you can see, EB3 has also progressed. For China, it has advanced by 8 months and for India, it has advanced by 4 months, which is not bad. So really, as you can see, it is a very good news for EB1 India and EB3 India, as well as EB1, EB2, EB3 for China. But it is a bad news for India EB2 category as dates haven't changed at all. But my prediction is these dates are going to advance in the near future. The reason I say this is because, as you know, these EB categories always have cap on them. There is a country limit, but there is also a provision that whenever there are visa numbers unused from different categories, they are spilled over into these backlog buckets. And that is the reason I think that these dates are going to advance in the next few months for EB1, EB2 and EB3. As you know, for the last several months, they haven't been issuing any green cards in the consulates abroad. Now, these green card numbers also contribute to these quota numbers. So for the last 4 months, there haven't been any visas or immigrant visas that have been issued in the consulates abroad. So there haven't been any green cards that have been processed. So those visa numbers should be available for these quotas for the people who are within the United States. So my theory is those numbers will be available for people who are already in the United States and in the pending adjustment of status. So I am expecting that all of these categories are going to see some advancements in the next few months, and certainly so by October 1st, because October 1st onwards is the new immigration calendar where the visa numbers for the next year become available. So not only we will have the spillover unused visa numbers from these consulates that have not been processed be available for these categories, but there will also be the new numbers from the next year becoming available from October 1st. So I'm expecting to see a big advancements in the dates for all of these categories. So now I would also like to mention that I'm not an immigration lawyer. So whatever I say in this video is only from my experience. So that's all I had in this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel. And I will see you in the next one.